It's called a regional fuel tax from Aucklanders for Aucklanders. But there's growing concern motorists outside Auckland may unwittingly also pay some of the new tax intended to help fix the transport woes in the country's largest city. The additional 11.5 cents a litre tax is due to be paid by Aucklanders from July, raising $160 million a year. But a string of lobby groups has warned a parliamentary select committee there's no way of being sure the oil companies won't spread the cost across the rest of the country. Our Auckland correspondent Todd Nile reports.
Auckland's Mayor Phil Goff is the champion of the regional fuel tax, and this is how he sees it working.
Let's get one thing straight. It's people in Auckland that are paying it, so this is paid by Aucklanders and visitors to Auckland.
Ken Shirley, who heads the trucking lobby, the Road Transport Forum, disagrees.
It's just an illusion to think that this tight ring fence around Auckland will mean that only Aucklanders pay for it. That's a political posturing, it's not commercial reality.
It's likely that from July, for every litre of fuel an Aucklander pumps, the oil company selling it will pay an extra 11.5 cents in tax. But whether that money actually comes from an Aucklander, rather than someone paying a higher price to the same oil company, say in Dunedin, is not clear. It's called price spreading and was a recurring theme as the Finance and Expenditure Select Committee sat in Auckland to hear views on the tax. The AA says its Auckland members are divided on it, and advisor Mark Stockdale says uncertainty over who really pays more is a problem.
Well, that undermines completely the regional fuel tax, fatally in our view, and motorists outside of Auckland will be deeply frustrated if they believe they are paying a few extra cents a litre in tax specifically to pay for Auckland projects.
The only oil company which appeared in Auckland was cut price operator Gull, and I asked its retail development manager Carl Mashevsky whether the tax bill could be funded from anywhere.
That's right, so there is the potential for that sort of cross-subsidisation. Yeah, you're right.
The AA wants the tax legislation to require the government's transport agency to monitor and report regularly on fuel price movements. Phil Goff believes there's enough scrutiny already.
The government and Parliament itself is a watchdog. You've seen that down at Otaki. When oil companies try to leverage the system to their own advantage, people will speak out angrily against that. And people will want to know if the petrol goes up excessively in other parts of the country, why that is the case.
There were other criticisms of the proposed tax. Michael Barnett from the Auckland Business Forum says the council and other local bodies should be selling assets instead of asking motorists to cough up.
They're sitting on $115 billion of asset and saying they can't fix these problems. In actual fact, they can.
David Aitken of the industry group National Road Carriers says the tax favours some operators.
If you are operating from outside of the region, you could have a competitive advantage over those within Auckland. And, you know, there's a number of trips that start outside of the Auckland region, either end up in Auckland or go through Auckland, and they'll be contributing nothing to it.
National Road Carriers would prefer congestion charging on certain routes in Auckland. But as well as impassioned support from Phil Goff, Hamilton City also wants to join the regional fuel tax party. Its Growth and Infrastructure Committee Chair David McPherson says Hamilton had to halve its proposed spending on infrastructure projects because it couldn't afford them.
Parts of Hamilton and parts of the North Waikato are actually growing faster at the moment as the spillover from Auckland happens. So we're seeing our Auckland's problem is not actually an Auckland problem, it's a Auckland to Hamilton growth corridor problem.
Hamilton wants to join the Regional Fuel Tax Club next year, 2 years earlier than the proposed date for councils outside Auckland to be able to make that move. Public consultation will continue in Auckland for another 10 days, with the empowering legislation expected to be passed late next month. I tamaki makaurau mō te hōtaka o te ahiahi, ko Todd Nile tēnei.